Today we're going to look at this Netatmo smart outdoor camera with siren.
That looks remarkably like a light thing to me, Gordon.
You're right, Gary. That's the other feature of this. It actually has a light built in. So is it a smart camera with a light or a light with a smart camera?
Well, you know me, I'm all about the ease of installation. The minute you mention the word smart, I get a little bit worried. But there only seems to be three connections on the back of that fitting, so it must be simple to fit. Do you agree?
Yeah, that's it. It is just designed to take down that outdoor light and put this in. So let's see how you got on installing one, Gary.
So this is what we get in the packet. The bracket's really important, Gordon. You can clearly see it also says up on it.
Yeah, well, that's always a top tip to follow the instructions.
It is. So this bracket needs to be mounted on the wall at an angle, obviously with the up position in the correct place, and then secured to the fabric of the building. Obviously, we're mimicking it here in the workshop. So screw the bracket on at an angle. Then we'll go through the process of making all the final connections. So cable next. It's likely that you'll have a fitting on a wall, possibly that you're taking off with its switching line, neutral and CPC already in place. This screw here, Gordon.
Yeah, right. What's that for?
Right, back this is really clever. Back this one back off. And you might have noticed a tie wrap or a cable tie on the actual light and camera itself. Just hook it on there.
Oh, and you're just trapping that with a screw, are you?
Yeah.
That's a sort of strain relief so it doesn't drop onto the floor.
Yeah, remember you'll be doing this at height. So the next thing I'm going to do is the CPC on there to also add a little bit of security as well. So nip that one on to earth the back plate, like so. And then it's just make those final connections. So pop in the switching line now. So it's straightforward, nice and simple. So take your old light fitting on, connect your new light and camera in place.
Okay, what's this for?
Introducing the bracket to hold the arm on. This allows us to rotate and tilt. But there's one more nice little thing beforehand. That bolt we saw earlier on for the cable tie.
All right, yes.
Just need to back that back off a little bit. And then there's a keyway.
All right, it's like a smiley face.
Yeah. I'm going to be 90 degrees out to start with. So I'll locate it into position and just watch now. Just pointing it out in there. And then I'm just going to rotate it for you. So now it's up and got to level it off.
Yeah, what are you going to do with that cable tie?
Well, I might come back to that in a minute.
Okay. So this bracket's also a swivel as well, so you can set the direction of the camera.
Yeah, so you've got both options. So just going to nip this one up now. I'm going to take a minute or two. You know what I'm like, Gordon, for making sure I'm level and in the right position.
You wouldn't want it out of trim, Gary.
Okay, tilt it and just make sure we're in the right position. Just a final adjustment. And then I've got to remember that cable tie, I think. I'll get my side cutters. Now you're a happy man. That was incredibly easy to fit, and I've actually fitted two. I fitted one inside for that demonstration there, but I've also fitted one outside, and we'll see the footage from that later on. You've had some experience before, Gordon, of actually fitting smart cameras. What's your feeling on other products that you've fitted?
Yeah, well, I was an early convert to smart technology, yeah, so I've installed a lot of other smart products, or supposedly smart products, on the market. And one thing, you know, this is the first time we've sort of seen that someone's actually thought about the installer. Yeah. i.e. it's easy to install. A lot of other systems, you have another box, a remote power supply, and then the wire between the camera and the power supply is pre-terminated, so you can't shorten it. So it's a case of where do you hide it? And this is obviously, you don't have that. It's just that simple mains connection, and it's direct to Wi-Fi, and that's just the start of the smart features in this.
It absolutely is, isn't it? So it's easy to install, and I've carried that process on about the ease. Now, when I'm thinking smart, I'm thinking backing it up to a cloud-based area. I may have to pay subscription and things like that. What have they done with that, Gordon?
Yeah, so again, the clever part of this is that actually all of the storage takes place in the device itself. There's an inbuilt SD card.
Okay.
And so therefore there's no need for a cloud service, although you could transfer the footage to your own Dropbox account,
okay,
things
yeah,
like that.
Sense.
But when you're using the app, obviously all smart things have an app, you're actually downloading the data from the camera itself.
So that's really good. So that removes the subscription-based system that other cameras have, is that true?
Yeah, it is. And that can be, yeah, if you put a few cameras in, that can be quite a substantial yearly investment you need to make to obviously keep up that cloud service.
So we've gone from easy install to thinking about the electrician and the end user with actually how we store the information. Then we got onto looking at the app, didn't we? And that's where you came into play. And how did you find the app?
Yeah, okay, I always get the difficult bit, and that's the commissioning procedure, Gary.
But was it difficult, Gordon?
Well, let's have a look. So we're going to add a camera to our system. So we've powered up the camera. It's in now, it's in a learning mode. It's waiting to be discovered. So we're going to go through there searching for camera. Oh, it's found the camera. So yeah, select the one we're going to add to our network. We're going to add it to our eFIXX network. Start the pairing process. And there's a instructor that's going to allow it onto the network. So some sort of reconnection and disconnection of the Wi-Fi is part of that process.
It's changed colour now. What's that doing?
That's infrared. Okay. Actually, here's the clever bit. We're going to scan the QR code to allow it onto the Apple HomeKit. It came in the box, so we've done that. So now we're going to finish pairing up. Flashing away. Yep, so now it's on the system. I'm going to add it to a room, Gary's view. We're not going to change any of the settings at this stage for the name of the camera or the Siri settings. There you can see the camera's now online. It's in an infrared mode. And there we can see it already. There's the live view. Oh, there's you, Gary. Oh. What are you doing out there?
That was good. That was quick. Okay.
It's quick, and you can see that this it often happens when you bring these systems online to start updating their firmware, which is quite normal. Oh, it's already detected a car at the end of the drive there. Oh, and you're back again, Gary. What are you doing now?
I'm in disguise this time. Put a hat on, took my jacket off. Yeah, I'm away with it.
There you go. Someone's just pinched the camera.
Well, that looked really simple. We saw it being used with the Apple HomeKit. Does it work with anything else, Gordon?
Yeah, it does. So it'll work with a lot of the other assistants out there at Google, and she who should not be named. And the other popular ones out there. You might not have spotted that, though, but the clever bit,
yeah.
I didn't have to put in any Wi-Fi passwords or anything. I just used this QR code because we were using the HomeKit one, but just have another version there. So it's actually the camera looks for the QR code.
It does.
And then it knows, so that's the pairing procedure. And we also found, we love this.
Yeah, this is a great bit, isn't it?
The red card. If you ever need to do a factory reset, you use the red card. You give the camera a red card and send it off your network and start again. And just thought that, again, that's just that. That's a nice, easy to use design feature. Sometimes you look at these things, try to do a factory reset for whatever reason.
Yes.
You might have moved house or... you know, you want to move it to another network, that can sometimes be a painful process. But yeah, we love the red card.
So we've got it on the wall, we've actually set it up, and obviously then we started playing around with it. We've had it for a couple of weeks on the actual go, haven't we, to really get used to all the features in it. So I think it's worth looking at some of those features now. Not all of them, just a few of them. Okay then, Gordon, walk me through some of these great features.
Okay, so we can dim the light, depending on the area you've installed it in. You may need it a brightly lit area, or may just want subtle illumination. And obviously we can have the light permanently switched on or in response to triggered events.
So like auto would be, you walk into the area, the lamp would come on, yeah?
Yeah, so it's an auto for a PIR. So let's just show that here. So we've got the lamp on auto mode there.
Okay.
Someone's going to walk into the area and switches on.
Brilliant. So that's really good. Now, when we're talking about areas, can we activate different areas based on perhaps something that we want to protect or be notified when somebody walks into it?
Yeah, so we can obviously have a dedicated detection area, so you might not want the lamp to trigger all of the time. So you're basically going to restrict the area where you get alerts from. So what I've done there, set up a little area on our eFIXX sign. So there's one area.
Okay, can you have more than one area as an alert area?
Yes, you can have multiple areas. What you can't do is have them overlapping. So there you can see I've set another area. And I've got to put it on our EV charge block we've looked at in a different video.
Don't think anyone's going to walk off with that though.
No.
Okay, so you've got two areas now. So in auto mode, obviously the light would come on and you can also set an alarm, or do you have to activate the alarm yourself?
No, so you have to set you get a trigger. So somebody walks into the area, and then you'll get an alert to say somebody is in the area, at which point you can choose whether to trigger the audible alarm to sort of, should I say, scare them off.
Okay, so we've had somebody in the area now. Oh, yeah, so there's an alert, and you can activate the alarm.
Yeah, okay. So I've activated the sounder.
And hopefully that would perhaps scare them off.
Yeah, hopefully.
Well, you touched on some of the great features there, Gordon. One we really liked, we didn't show in there, is the downloading the day in 60 seconds, where it shows you the full footage of that day. That's really good, isn't it?
Yeah, it's been really good for us, because it's like, yeah, people are saying, oh, did that parcel get delivered yesterday? You can see all that things. It's, you know, those detection modes as well, it does pick up, you know, it'll detect the difference between a person,
yeah,
a car, another object, or even a pet. And then we've discovered there's even a cat regularly visits our yard.
Well, here's some proof. The camera picked up this cat one evening, Gordon.
Yeah, now obviously that is a cat, but if it wasn't a cat and had been sort of falsely the triggered, you can actually train the algorithm to improve itself and ignore certain types of event. And also notice it detected you there, Gary, as well. And you, you said you were here at 8 o'clock this morning, but somehow the camera somehow suggests it was more like a quarter to nine.
You've caught me out yet again. And talking about the camera, it's a 1080p camera, and I think the range on it is about 20 meters.
The detection range is about 20 meters. And you can obviously, you can zoom in up to 8 times digital zoom in on the camera as well. And that's, again, that's, so we've lived with it now for a couple of weeks, and it's been picking up some really, some great footage.
Yeah.
You know, there was a, there was an image of someone sweeping up at some point. Obviously, we're not going to share that because that's just a myth.
Yeah, a rumour and a myth.
A rumour and a myth.
The light fin itself is rated at 12 watts LED, which is 120 watts in old money.
Yeah, in halogen terms. Yeah, and again, it's that feature that the camera itself is doing the switching, so you don't necessarily need a PIR. And obviously, we've got it set up so it automatically switches on. You can just leave it in an infrared mode.
Yeah.
And a lot of cameras have infrared. And this one's quite visible, actually, which again is that other level of visible deterrent. And then you couple that with the siren that you can trigger, and I think that's a really powerful feature.
Yeah, that startle people with the siren from the remote triggering is really good. Mm. Well, let's think about the Netatmo range now. So let's say I want to get more involved. I can take on the Pro installer.
Yeah, so this is obviously geared up towards electricians.
Yes.
And there's some advantages there. Obviously, there's a great training package that goes with it to get you comfortable with installing this stuff. And it, you know, we're in the early days of this. You know, we're learning this system as well. We've got a whole load of other stuff behind us that we're going to plug through in the range. There's a dedicated phone line that you can phone up,
okay,
obviously, to get advice, and probably, you know, that those early days, those first few installs, that can be quite important. And there's a separate line for also for the customer to phone up as well, so you don't end up running a help desk for the customer. You know, there's loads of features in there that are for the customer that probably they want to explore.
And once you've done that training, you can be registered on their website so people can visibly see that you're a local installer within your area. Warranty is really important. So I become a Pro installer, I now get a 4-year warranty, is that correct, Gordon?
Yeah, it is. So that extends the warranty from 2 years to 4 years. And obviously, again, there's a few Pro installer programs around, but not many of them have many real advantages. But that being able to offer an extended warranty because you've installed it, you know, that's, again, it's a tangible benefit that the customer can see.
And you've installed it, and I would suggest it was easy to install, and we commissioned it really easy. Lots of eases in here. So having the 2-year warranty on top of the 2-year warranty, giving you 4-year warranty, obviously is an added bonus to you being the installer. So as always, we're interested in your comments. Have you fitted any of the range from Netatmo, the ones behind us here? What's your feeling on those? How did you find setting them up? We'd love to hear those comments. Are you thinking about fitting them in the future as you delve into the world of smart? As always, we're interested in your feedback and your comments. Please leave them below, and we'll get back to as many as we can.